Welcome to September 28th meeting of the Rotary Club of Louisville. I'm Kevin, the president of the club, all our fellows. I'm glad you're in front of the newly returned and set of backs. Hello?
Sorry.
Kelly can hear me, he's in the front row, it's more you guys. For somebody to check that out, just yell, I guess. We just recently learned the loss of a longtime member, actually a few months ago, we just found out recently. And I know about the new member, Harry Bryan, a longtime club member. He joined the club in 1995. He was a Paul Harris fellow, he was a resident of St. X, from Harvard. Recently served the Navy during World War II. He graduated from JV School in good health. As a professional mechanical engineer, he co-founded CNI Engineering and served as president and CEO of the company before retiring. Harry was a Kentucky Colonel, past president of the Kentucky Square Dance Association, board member and volunteer at the Paul School, and active member of our club, and also Southeast Christian Church. Please join me in a moment of silence in his memory. Providing your invitation today is Kelly Burke, co-chair of the Social Affairs and Social Activities Committee. We've done that for years. Great job at it. And applaud us.
Thank you, President Kevin. Bow heads. We pray for your blessings as we gather together in the name of Rotary. We pray for all our clubs around the world. We pray for their leaders and members. We pray that we may work together to improve life on earth through service to our communities, our countries, and the world. Let us dedicate ourselves to the ideas of this great Louisville Rotary Club organization, that we as Rotarians will endeavor to serve our community through service projects, develop and nurture a spirit of fellowship, promote a creative climate that should be all in favor of.
Thanks, Joy. The meeting is before we plant and before we test and play, but it's true for our fire, President of the Central Electronic Office Machines and Appliances.
Thank you, President. Join me in the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Now for the four-way test.
It is the truth.
Tom Leckenridge, the second. I am the district governor for this year, and I brought with me Dick Lee, who is of Scottsville, and he is going to be talking about major donors and what stand up there, so they'll know. So if you have some money you want to get to the foundation, Dick will take it, okay? And with him also, Aaron Crowe, who is one of my assistant governors for the Scottsville area. And so thank you for coming with me. That's all we have tonight.
Thanks, John. At this time, I'd like to recognize some Rotarians in the spotlight. We always have a couple. It's pretty impressive. Congrats to Mayor Smith and Harper House of Global, who cut the ribbon of the new Eastern Generational Life Center on Friday. The first of Shannon, Kentucky, the facility is a place where adults with disabilities, children, and elders receive services in the future as an innovative model to place them together for planned and home life too. Huge shout out to Ashley Brower for shining the spotlight on Rotary, and thank you to Vernon Foster and the U of L College of Business for the great feature. Now it's my pleasure to introduce today's speaker. Tom's been around for a while, so let's get a little time here. Okay. Tom Green is a Rotarian in every sense. He's a charter member of the Bardstown Rotary Club in 1980, served as club president in 81. He's held multiple leadership roles in his club, particularly in the area of youth service. His service includes starting an interact club at Bethlehem High School, helping establish a Cody Kid service project in 2019, providing leadership to shelter through the Clothed for Kids project, which involved not only the Barstown Club, but also local merchants, banks, civic clubs, facilities serving the public and private school systems in the Barstown area. Tom is a multiple-year former scholar. He has served as an assistant governor, served as the district PFC team, and currently serves as the district global scholarship. So the one scholarship that he received, and most of some of them are qualified, I'm not sure. Tom has been schooled in what it means to be run there by his father. Tom Becker Green Sr., who was the district governor in 1962. In 1972, he served on the Rotary International Board of Directors in Evanston, Illinois, in 1886. His father was actually the youngest district governor in 67 ever. Tom holds an AB degree in education at the University of Kentucky, and attended the ECC, University of Louisville, and EKU for advanced students. Over the years, Tom has taught in school, coached football, baseball, and basketball. He's owned his own grocery business, plus part of Jim T. Nelson property, and part of Bardstown Rotary. Tom is going to live to celebrate the 52nd wedding anniversary. By the way, I checked on Google, that's more than the average in the U.S. February 2023, they're the parents of 3 daughters, 10 grandchildren, and 3 great-grandchildren. Welcome, Tom. Thanks a lot.
Bylaws, It says if the president does not have a president-elect to follow him, he gets to serve a second term. And I do have a couple of those clubs that are doing that. Joe McWilliams could be here today, but he is the AG for this area. And I had many a good conversation with Elaine as we were trying to straighten out when and where I was going to come. At this time, I want to honor you all on the multiple times that you all have been a star club, which allows you all to have the district help pay for some of those. Congratulations on that. I'd like to give you a lapel pin. And also, this is this year's banner. And, you might want to hang it on the rail or something. But again, like I said, thank you for all that you do. Let me go a little bit further. Congratulations, your star club was 156 per capita, which is great. But the Paducah's star club average was, Mike, was it $2,560-something per member? They had an arts fund member that came through for them. You've got 360 members according to Rotary International.
350 a couple months ago.
Okay. So they've got you 360. The average for the district is 30%, so y'all, as far as the number of female members you have, you're doing great. I would like to see it go up a little bit, though. Also, the other things that I want to congratulate you on is you, number one, you are the oldest club in the district. You were chartered in 1912.
That's when we were founded, about our application.
And the different projects that you do, and they're outstanding, the way that you raise money. You've got the West End, is that elementary school that you raise money for there? As far as the literacy program, you have a Habitat for Humanity. You have your Rotary Club of Lowell that does a lot of things as far as West End housing. And you're first in the nation in effort to create a $5 million revolving loan fund that helps those low to moderate income homeowners. So you all are doing very well. Also, Nancy Stewart passed district governor. She started a special program that was not only been doing part of the club plus since 1985, but this year to kind of help, I guess, send that a little bit quicker along. We have now a Polio Plus Society, and you all have eight members there that I would like to honor at this time, that they got their initial pin, and if you have not got it yet, I've got one for you. So, Michael, you got yours? I'll tell you what, let's do a photo walk. After those people who are on that list right there, if you would come up here first. And so, Rick.
Mike and I had a conversation here earlier that they
interactive people will also be getting involved in the speech contest. So if you have anything to do with the interact clubs, please get them involved in the speech contest that we're having right now and this year. And the finals will be in the district conference, and the person that wins it will walk away with, where did mine go?
Right here.
What's the total check to walk away with?
22 to 2400.
$2,200, I believe. Okay. So we can get them involved. We talked about with the president these different things, and I am big at the youth clubs. Like I said, we're doing Riley here on October the 5th through the 8th. We have an exchange program. Y'all do remember that it's been about 12, 14 years ago we had student exchanges. I had the very first one, believe it or not. I'm that old. In 1985, I had a young lady from Australia who came and visited me, and I just went back, and when I went to Melbourne for the international convention, she flew down from Sydney to Melbourne with her 22-year-old daughter to meet me and my 22-year-old granddaughter. And by the way, both of them have been Facebooking forever. So anyway, it was a good reunion at that point. Y'all do a great job working on grants. And the very last one here, I would like to see everyone get on myrotary.org, doesn't have to be /learn, but put your information, your data on myrotary.org. If you are a new member, you're going to get on the Rotary, myrotary.org/learning. The International has at least 3,000 videos for you to learn just about anything you want to learn about Rotary International. The people that are coming into the club, they need to know what is expected of them to be a good member. So if you're a fairly new member, let's get them to get myrotary.org, and for that person to /learning, and it's a 10-minute video. So again, it would be great to get on. Okay. Dates that are coming up. Like I said, Violet is going to be next week. Claire, where's Claire? Claire is in charge. She's the chairman of the Global Scholarship, and I want to make sure she would call me out if I didn't have these dates up there. But again, you have a deadline for an application for a Global Scholarship. That is in December the 15th. And on January the 20th, you're going to be interviewed. We usually interview about what, 5 or 6?
Half a dozen.
So again, like I said, hopefully you can be part of that process. On May the 10th and 11th, we have our district conference here in Jefferson County. It is at the Marriott East. There's going to be all different types of programs and keynote speakers. The new, we usually give out about 27 awards, okay? And you don't get quite a bit. But we're going to bring back, I think for a year or two, we have missed, okay, Service Above Self Award. So we will be giving out a Service Above Self. If you have somebody in your club that soars above the average person, the average Rotarian, we would like for you to get them to apply, tell us what extra things that they're doing in this community, and hopefully bring home an award. Also, the International President, his theme again is create hope in the world. Really what he wants to talk about is for you to have awareness to the mental health problems that we have, not just in our community, but in the world globally. So again, we're going to give out an award. And by the way, you all are only competing against 3 other clubs. Is that right, in your division? So you're only going to be competing against 3 other clubs. Then there's a Division 3, a Division 2, and a Division 1. So hopefully we'll have people that will be picking up those new awards, plus the awards that we get all the time. Dick wanted to make sure that you understood that there is a banquet for major donors on May the 9th.
You want to?
Oh, okay. Sorry, I got to. Yeah, I know, you and me.
We will.
Well, okay, so if anybody wants to talk to Dick about being a major donor, okay, he will be free after the meeting, and he might get, if I don't talk too long, he might be able to get up here for a little bit. Again, if you're working on district grants, okay, your interim report has to be in about February the 14th. Your final report has to be in about May the 31st. However, if you're doing a district grant, and that district grant is going to be finished prior to the February date, just go ahead and send in your final report in February. You don't have to wait for that. Okay? So everybody understands those dates that are coming up. Polio Plus, when I was in Memphis this past week, Barry Razin, who is the foundation chair for Rotary International, he explained to me that there's all kinds of money being raised, but the point is that how many vaccinations are going out? Well, he was in Pakistan. Just in Pakistan, we are vaccinating 300,000 children in 1 year. But they have to send out 80,000 troops to keep those volunteers safe. I think it's been over, I don't know, Rick might be able to tell me, it's been over about the last 4 or 5 years, they've had about 40 volunteers that have been killed. So anyway, they need their protection. That's 600 million vaccines a year that we're giving out, okay? And so, I'm talking to Rotarians now, but two things I wanted to inform you of is that you do not have to be a Rotarian to give to Polio Plus, okay? And you do not have to be a Rotarian to give to our foundation or anything that has to do with our foundation, major donors, etc. So again, if you're looking to help us raise money, you do not have to be talking to a Rotarian. Go outside your realm of possibilities and talk to the people out in the community. Say, we are doing this with the foundation money. Could you please help us? Whether it be Polio Plus, whether it be the environment, all the areas of focus that we have, okay? See if you have some friends out there that has, a devotion of helping somebody somewhere in the world. I'm going to skip that, except for the fact that we're trying to do some things. Kevin has got, already has his goals and stuff, but I'm going to tell you that the president cannot do it alone. He needs support from his club, from his board. So again, once you find out what all the goals are for this club, raise a hand and say, I'd like to help in this avenue, okay? And Gordon McNally, who is the president of RI, he's the one that put out the Create Hope in the World. And the only thing I'm trying to, tell everybody is that when I say the word hope, there's a lot of people that aren't sure what hope is. And hope, basically, we've been through destructive wars. We've been through a pandemic. We're trying to figure out how we can raise up those people that are getting a little bit depressed and those people that are looking for a change. And so basically, we want you all to follow this theme and to find out how your club can restore hope in your community, in your district, in your country, and globally. So again, we're looking for those people to step up and help us here. What is hope? I've got all these definitions here, but I'm just going to go to the very first one on my bottom claim. Hope is what Rotary claims and is done for a very long period of time. We've had all these projects that we've done over the years, all this lifting people up. If we want you to realize that what does Rotary do for hope? Well, first of all, Rotary has a joyful expectation for what's going to happen in the future. We are positive thinkers. We're going to take the things that we've done in the past and we're going to promote them and say we can make a difference. So all we want to do is make sure that right now, in the present, we are changing those things that need to be changed to help out our community and the world. So, mental health and well-being is what we're going to concentrate on right now. And I'm going to expand that a little bit here, but we're going to create change across the globe in our communities and in ourselves. And when I talk about in ourselves, I don't know how many people in this room understand that there's been some time in the past that you've done something good for somebody. You have helped them up, got them up, you got a hand up. You basically are helping somebody there. In my life, I've had many different things that, you know, I coached, I taught, done, I guess, community service, whatever it might be. But I always had that one person come up, tap me on the shoulder, and says, can you remember 25 years ago you did this for me? Well, that's the blessing in return for me. I mean, I am blessed that I have somebody that remembers me doing something to help them. And they're helping me when they recognize the fact that, you know, there are people out there in the world who can't do that. So my question to you all and Kevin is, where do you start? That's where the goals, right? I want to, you know, we're going to go all the way down to the second line. So President Gordon McAnally, he thinks that Rotary members should offer hope to those affected by mental health challenges. We've been in a crisis here over the last number of years. It's been exacerbated by COVID-19. Many people have lost family members. Many more have found their social networks have been uprooted. And the young people, especially, they have had their educational and developmental paths interrupted. You see on the news every once in a while, reading levels are now to 25% are reading at grade level, or 21% are doing math at grade level. Well, somehow, we're going to jump up and we're going to say, where can we go or how can we help those people? So those are the things that we're going to do and help on these. These are all different mental health issues. And if you're looking at the award that I talked about at the district conference, you're not going to pick out just one, say, I'm going to help with mental health. You can sit there and you can talk about the bullying that goes on in school. You're going to talk about teenage suicide. You're going to talk about the veterans that come back and are having problems. Is it STPD? Or do I have the PTSD?
PTSD.
PTSD. So those veterans that are troubled with that. There's all kinds of people that are out there that you're going to look and assist them and help them in whatever area that you can do to help. So you're not going to have to do all the mental health work. You're just going to have to figure out, I can help in this area. So that's all I'm asking, is for people to jump up and help somewhere and be aware that there's a problem with mental health in our area and also in the world.
Learning
center reports that are available there. So you're going to go myrotary.org/learning, and they will be able to see all the different videos that are going to help educate them as far as membership goes. And also, it doesn't hurt for somehow to go back, whether you be treasurer or board member or whatever it might be, okay? If you'll go to myrotary.org, get registered, and then /onlearning, they'll have videos that you can learn from also. Okay? So anyway, I'd like to congratulate the little club for all the great things they've done. However, this is a new year. Kevin is going to make sure things are better. Do a better job this year. Congratulations.
Recognition is what you want to give and help. $100. How many of you, I see several in here that have reached a point when you've got an IRA, you got a minimum distribution. How many of you have a minimum distribution in your IRA? Okay. Are you taking that and paying tax on it every year? What are you doing with it, Rick?
UCB, qualified charitable deduction.
Exactly. You can do the same thing to Rotary. So think about that. There's nothing out of your pocket whatsoever, not free tax. So you get that. Rotary Grant is another way. I think if I encourage you to do anything for being a mega donor, giving the annual fund, I got 100 points from an anonymous donor for awards of Paul Harris. If you can give me the answer to a quote by a very famous Rotary, we make a living by what we get. We make a life by what we give. Who said that?
Paul Harris.
Good try. No.
He smoked a cigar.
You read it. You read my notes.
I didn't know that. I didn't know that.
You read my notes there.
I know. I just wanted to do the thing. You're working together.
Yeah. Okay. I'll give you a hint.
Good job.
Not born of the last century. He smoked a cigar. He visited the U.S. a few times.
Mark Twain.
Who?
Mark Twain.
Winston Churchill.
Who?
Winston Churchill.
Winston Churchill. Give me your number, your ID number, and I'll give you the I'll be glad to talk with you about major donor or any other avenue of giving some money to Rotary Foundation. It comes back to us. Back to our communities, and we want to give it to Rick. We can get it to El Salvador or some other country to run the grant service. So,
thank you. Thank you. I have a question. Tom Brown, a daughter of family, and his father's governor, district governor, 39 times. You are a long visit. Just tell us how well you made you who you are.
Well, really, you know, Rotary has affected me in many ways. I'm going to go back to youth exchange, and I'm hoping that those people that might be interested, or not other people that are interested, we have an exchange student that I had the very first one that came from Australia, and then I had 11 others that came over the next 15 years, and so they were part of our life. I had three daughters, and they got a good education from Bethlehem High School. They got a good education from the colleges they went to. But the best education they got was be involved with people that were around the world. And they figured out that Bardstown was in the center of the universe. So they got their education from abroad. And then, like I said, as far as traveling and meeting people, there's a whole lot of very interesting people in the world that are members of Rotary. So if you go to a district conference or if you go to an international conference, by the way, it's Singapore this year, and you'll meet some of the greatest people in the world.
One more task before you get ready to wrap up here, and it's going to be the same door prize, which is really good, but two tickets to attend a lot of those at Meet the Arts reception at Church of Mass, September 28th. Oh, it's nice. In the Homestead Club, we're in Twilight for your two reasons.
That's it. Like on the bottom or on the top?
Yeah. Last 4 digits.
Last 4 digits. 2303. 2303.
Okay. Do you have to put your name down? Sure. Actually, one last announcement. How many of you went to the event when Jeff Robb spoke at the Women's Club. That's pretty good. We have actually a better situation for basketball. We're actually going to attend the practice. October, and that's very rare. You can't normally do that. It's October 23rd, which is a Monday. a meeting at 3:15 when we go, where we go in, 3 o'clock in the parking lot nearby. But it's going to be practice from 3:30 to 6, 3:30 to 5, I'm sorry. And then talk and Q&A by Coach Kenny Payne. So that's a big deal up to you. And I suggest all this, there's a minimum, say maximum, of 100 people. You'd like to have a Rotary get the chance, but you could bring a member, a guest. It's somebody that, you know, something that might show people how to work with the profession and do different things. So we'll get more information on that as far as it's a little bit hard for us today, but that's a pretty big deal. But again, make sure that's, you don't just walk into practice, you want in this group. So if you show up late, you're not going to practice. If you show up on time, we're not going to throw the ball on the board.
Kings are going to let you in.
This coach isn't going to be here, right?
Would anybody need a card so in case they want to get in touch with me later in the year on any program that you're talking about?
And next week, our speaker is Brian Quarles. Many of you know him, the Commissioner of Agriculture. So we've actually been doing it this coming month, next week, as usual. And I don't think there are too many guests, but Craig Sherman will be over there, just in case. I'll be here. Once I can show you what's going on. Please, thanks a lot.